I'm going to be your nurse practitioner today, and we're going to do a full head-to-toe assessment with your health, testing everything from your cranial nerves to your stomach, your breathing rate, your pulse, and any general abnormalities. Hopefully we don't find any, but nonetheless, just going to do a very general, thorough health assessment. To confirm, can you tell me what your height and your weight are, or approximation? Okay. Alright, well, we're going to start with your vision here. So I just want to take a couple of seconds here. I'm going to hold fingers up on each side. Just look straight forward. I want you to tell me which side wiggles and which side does not, okay? Ready? Okay. Move further out. I want you to look over here at this finger here and tell me when you can see the other hand enter the picture, okay? Okay. Same over here. Look at this finger here. Take a quick look at your eyes here. Pull down on your eyelids. Okay. Do you mind if I palpate your face just a little bit here? Any areas of tenderness that you want me to take notice of? Okay. I'm going to take a red light here. And this is going to be a little bit different than your typical white light because this will make your eye dilate and restrict a lot quicker. Okay. I know it's not always that comfortable. I'll do the same with the white light. Look straight forward, okay? Very close. I want you to cover your right eye. Uncover. Cover. Uncover. Okay. Gonna do the same on the other side. Cover up your left eye. Uncover. Cover. Uncover. Okay. The reason why we do that is a lot of times we just want to make sure that your pupil can dilate and restrict. Okay, I'm just going to take a very quick visual assessment of your arms. I want to see the skin, whether or not you have any missing patches of hair, if you have any discoloration, any dryness. Okay. I might just squeeze your biceps and your triceps a little bit. Your forearms. Do you struggle with dry skin? Yeah, it's the winter time for a lot of folks. But no abnormal areas of extreme heat or cold, and no missing patches of hair. Okay, that's good. I'm gonna put my gloves on here because I'm going to be looking into your mouth and your nose. Do you have any allergies, such as latex, that I should be aware of? Okay. These are nitrile, so they shouldn't. Okay. Some of my tools might have it, though. Tilting your head back so that I can take a look into your nostrils. And I'm just gonna touch the very tip of your nose. I'm gonna test your ability to smell. I want you to close one nostril. I'm going to take a odor here. Just put it underneath your nose. Okay. Can you hold the other side? And does that seem to be equal on each side? Okay. Any kind of sinus pressure or any abnormalities and any abnormal sensations in different areas in your nose? Okay. Do you mind if I palpate your face a little bit more? Go into your scalp a little bit. Behind your ears. Move along down to your jaw. Right here on your sinuses. Come down to your nose. Come underneath your eyes. And your TMJ here. Clench your jaws. Protrude. Do you mind opening up your mouth? Stick out your tongue. Lift your tongue to the roof of your mouth. And then side. Side. Looks good. Go ahead and close your mouth. Okay, use a tongue depressor here to press down on your tongue. Gag reflex is never a fun exercise. Try to relax your jaw a little bit, okay? Gonna move on to your ears. I'm gonna palpate. get really close up to here, so I'm gonna take a look on the inside. Just gonna use my little light. Can you clench your jaw for me? Good. Okay, clench. Okay. Relax. Do you struggle with your ears at all? Do you have any, are you prone to infection or anything like that? We'll get you some ear drops that you can try for a week and see whether or not that improves. Mm-hmm. Typically with any kind of itchiness in the ears, that can be fungal or bacterial. And as an example, when we get out of the shower and we have water in our ears, if that doesn't get dried properly, you can get it to start to have a bacterial growth or a fungal growth. But it's manageable. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm gonna take a look in your other ear. Sample that out, that way we can send it off to the lab to find out if it's bacterial or if it's fungal, and then we can get to the appropriate treatments. Okay. We'll start off with an antibacterial. It's most common, but in the case that it's not, then we get a culture back. I'll get some from the other ear. So this next exercise, I'm going to be taking a tuning fork, and I'm going to be placing it directly on your scalp behind your ears, and I want you to tell me when you stop hearing that vibration, okay? Okay. I'm going to do the same, but I'm going to hold this just outside your ear. And this is going to be to test whether or not your bone vibration is stronger or your air vibration, okay? And tell me when you stop hearing it. Okay. So the air vibration is much stronger, longer. Okay. I'm going to do the same on the back of your ear. And again, without touching your scalp. That's to be expected. I'm going to place this on the top of your head, and I want you to tell me when you stop feeling it as well. And tell me when it stops. That's normal. I want you to hold your head still, and I want you to watch the finger that moves. Keep your head in the forward position, okay? A couple of motions, and I want you to follow the finger. Keep your head straight. I'm going to use a more specific point of light here, and I want you to follow the light. And I know that this is going to strain a little bit because your eye is going to want to dilate at the same time. Follow the light, okay? Keep your head still. Good job. I'm going to place my hands on your cheek. I want you to puff your cheeks out. Go. And don't let me push inward, okay? And puff. Good. Good job. I'm going to press on your temple area, and I want you to clench your jaw. Uncomfortable at all when I press. Okay. I want you to raise your eyebrows. I'm going to try to push down on them. Don't let me push down, okay? Again. Okay. I want you to squint your eyes shut. Don't let me open them. I'm going to whisper one word in each side of your ear, and I want you to tell me best you can what word is it I'm pronouncing, okay? Wednesday. Correct. Saturday. Good. Okay, I'm going to inspect your neck. And your glands, your trachea. Okay. Move your esophagus just a little bit here, side to side. This could be a little uncomfortable, but it shouldn't hurt. Okay. Can you turn your head to one side here, and I'm going to feel? Side. Thank you. I want you to swallow. Okay. You can look forward. Good job. Tilt your head all the way back. Okay. Chin to your chest. Side to side. Okay. Good, good. See a full range of motion. That's good. Do you feel anything unusual when you rotate? Do you feel your neck popping or anything like that? Yeah. Sometimes as we get older, they make more noise. Alright, I'm going to feel the back of your skull area where your neck meets your skull. I'm going to palpate your top of the chest here, where your clavicle is, where your windpipe is. Go ahead and swallow. Okay. Swallow again. Good, good. Okay. Now one shoulder at a time. I'd like to have you lift up. I'm going to feel your shoulder as you move right. Okay. And up. And up again. Okay. Take your elbow, fold up. One arm at a time. I want you to pull into your chest, and I'm going to pull in the opposite direction. I want you to resist me, okay? Good job. We're going to do the same. I'm going to push towards you. I want you to push away. Okay. And now onto your right. Go ahead and lift up your arm. One more time. Again. Pull in. And push. Resist. Good job. Good job. Now we do have some lymph glands in our biceps and our triceps, so I'm going to a little bit of pressure in those areas just to feel for them. I'm going to use my thumbs a little bit here, so there's going to feel some pretty precise pressure. Onto your forearm. my fingertips to press inward. Do some general testing and palpating of your spine. Also want to check to see how straight it is when you sit upwards. Okay. Alright, I'm going to go around your back. Your clothing to the side here so that I can see your back a little bit better. I'm going to press on each side of your spine here with my fingertips, so you're going to feel a bit of precise pressure. I'm going to listen to your lungs on the back here. So I want you to just breathe normally for me, okay? Take a deep breath in for me. Hold it. And exhale. Again. And exhale. Okay. And again. One more time for me. I'm going to be using the bell and my stethoscope here, and I'm going to just slide this in underneath your left arm. I want to take a listen to the chambers of your heart from the back. And you can just breathe normally. I want you to say the word 99. Okay. I'm going to just tap on your back a little bit here. Just listening for the reverb. Alright, I'm going to palpate a little bit lower down towards your lumbar vertebrae. Do you suffer from any kind of lower back pain or anything like that? By your shoulders, can you go ahead and push your left shoulder back a little bit? Okay. And then shrug. Beautiful. Okay. What about with your right shoulder? It appears to be even. Mm-hmm. transverse a little bit here, leading up to your neck. The other side. Okay, beautiful. Get down your spine looks pretty straight here. Have you had any major back problems, any kind of surgeries, injuries? Hurts. That feels good. That's good. Okay. We're going to press in where your kidneys are, but very gently. Any pain there? Yeah, about on this side. No? Good. Beautiful. Alrighty.
Alright, I'm going to listen to your chest from the front, and this is going to be your anterior. I want you to start just by breathing normally. Do you mind saying the word 99? 2 different valves of your heart, different chambers. I don't hear any murmurs, any kind of echoes or reverbs. No, sounds good. In your front. I want you to take a deep breath in for me, okay? I want you to say the word 99. 99. Okay. Your breathing sounds good. Your airways sound very good. I'm going to have you lay down on your back. We're going to listen to your heart and then examine your tummy, okay? Okay. Let's get you comfortable. Lay you down on the bed. Thank you. Are you comfortable? Okay. I'm going to just start by listening to your heart as you are laying down. So I want you to just go ahead and breathe normally for me. I just want to listen to the 4 chambers of your heart.
I'm going to listen to your belly. I'm going to apply a little bit of pressure to your stomach here. Is that okay? Digestion sounds normal. I'm going to take just a couple of moments here and to depress into your stomach and just palpate the area a little bit. Is that okay? I'm just going to start out pretty light here. I'm going to try to palpate your liver. Okay. Now a little bit deeper depressions, and please tell me if this is just uncomfortable, okay? It's okay. Any pain or tenderness? Okay. Now a little bit deeper right here. Into your lymph glands right here, right about where your hip is, okay? Just feeling for any tenderness, any small areas that are elevated with heat. Reach one hand underneath your side here. Palpate on both sides. Any areas of discomfort there? That's good. Same on the other side. Tap on your tummy a little bit. Okay, I'm also going to tap on the lower end of your ribs here. Is that okay? Sounds good. Okay, let's get you to sit back up. I'll put my gloves back on. Okay, do you mind holding out your hands? Just hold your hands very steady for me, okay? You don't tend to have any tremors or anything like that. Go ahead and squeeze my fingers. Go ahead, give them a good squeeze. Okay. It's even on both sides. Okay. I'm going to take a better look at both of your hands here. Palpate your wrist a little bit. Just flex each one of your fingers. Okay. I'm going to pinch your fingernail and watch to see blood flow returns rather quickly. Good. Indication of good circulation. Hand on your thumb. Good. Same with the other side. Palpating your wrist a little. Just rotating each individual finger. Range of motion there. And then squeezing your fingernails. Good. Good circulation in your fingers. Mm-hmm. Okay. For coordination, I want you to hold one hand out. Test your reflexes. Just hold out to your left arm here, put it on your elbow. In front of your elbow. Your wrists. Down to your legs here, and I'm going to do very similar. Okay. I'm going to test the reflexes in your knees here. Okay. Just try to relax. And the other side. Your reflexes are good. Now I'm going to take one of your legs and I'm going to pull it towards me and I want you to resist. Okay. I'll pull back. Okay. I'm going to push and you push forward. Okay. I'm going to try to push your ankle down. I want you to pull it up. Again, I'm going to pull on your leg, I'm going to pull it forward, you pull it back. Push. Good job. Now your heel, your arms are at your ankle. And then down. Good job. Now the heat. The temperature of your legs is even on both sides. Do nails look good? No blisters, scars, lesions, anything like that? Beautiful. I'm gonna check for the pulses in your ankles and then I'm gonna move up towards the other pulses. Okay, on the tops of your feet. It's even on both sides, and that's what we want. Behind your knees. I'm gonna press into your hip area, okay. Same.
under your ribs. By your neck. And your temples. Okay. Yep. They're all equal. That's good. Alright, I'm going to place something in your hand. I want you to close your eyes. And I want you to feel around and tell me what you believe it is, okay? Look at your eyes and also the skin surrounding your eyes. So your blood vessels.
Yep.
Is it okay if I get really close to you?
Okay.
Same with your other eye. Use my other magnifying glass, a more broad range, especially area of the skin. Side. Has a rather sharp
surface. This is going to be much different than when I touch it with my fingertip, and I want you to tell me what it is. Close your eyes. Okay. Is that the same sensation that you feel over here? Okay. On your face? Okay. What about on the other side? Does that feel equal? Okay. On your cheeks? Equal on each side. You can quite clearly tell the difference between them. Okay, wonderful. Well, I think that you have a good, clear bill of health, at least, with the most obvious. And I would like to schedule an appointment to get a closer look at your ears, especially once we get that sample back, so we know how to properly treat it. So we'll do a very thorough ear cleaning, maybe down the road. Okay. Your pulse, your blood pressure, everything seems to be very normal. Mm-hmm, within a healthy range. Okay. Well, we'll see maybe in a couple of days or a couple of weeks, depending on how those labs come back by your ears. Are there any other concerns that you have for me? Okay. Well then, I will see you in a future visit. In the meantime, take care of yourself. Good seeing you.